While we are going and talking about this, I have to talk about both Yogi and Phobia, man. Phobia Anoop Dastakar, what can I say about him? Backbone of Indian gaming. He is the rock star who goes and makes everything happen. He's been on the phones with cafes, with players, on rules, running around, and Yogi sitting out of the back, the guy who goes and runs everything from like a super, super organizer. He is Mr. Phenomenal. Thank you, Yogi. Thank you, Anoop, for going and doing this. I couldn't have done this without you. You guys are the rock stars. And Alienware, guys, what can I say about them? They're paying $5,000 for Indians to go ahead and play this, and tickets, and this biggest prize money that is coming in, huge support coming in from them. You have to, the least you can go ahead and do is go back to their page and say thank you, Alienware. We'd really love it if you can just say that word. You don't have to go buy their product. If you can, go buy their product. But if you can't, just go and tell them, we love you, Alienware. Thank you for doing this for India. Thank you for doing it for the Dota 2 community. And I'm not going to bore everyone in there. I'm going to focus on the game. Great first bans. Rohit's favorite bans coming in. Siren goes down. Lycan goes down. What do you think? TA goes down.
Yeah, that Prophet, Vo'SK have played like 2-3 games of that Prophet. They played the first game of the DP against Elunes only, and then again against ATE.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, it should be, it is like one of the strongest picks for Vo'SK at the moment. So it is a good ban coming out from Elunes, and then we have the TA and Naga Siren, the normal bans.
There you go. If you actually look at what was the last map, I have not got it, and that's a great tip for me for the next time. I'll try and go ahead and show, if ever there is a rematch, I'd like to show what are the bans and the picks that were taken last time between teams. That'd be really good. Everyone's pitching for Elunes in the chat. come on, guys, no one wants to go ahead and support Vo'SK? Someone support Vo'SK. No, I don't say nobody's good, but that's okay. You know what? I'll support Vo'SK just because they are the underdogs. I love underdogs, man. It'd be such a cool story for them to go ahead and.
Okay, Sheko is there to support.
Oh, Sheko, go Sheko! I'm with you, man. Come on, let's support the underdog. I think Elunes is definitely the better team here, not having dropped a single match, which is there. But let's not go ahead and discount Vo'SK. Okay, they're solid team. Go Vo'SK. Go Dota 2.
Yeah, and Daxi again, picked by Vo'SK. They played like 3-4 games of Daxi whenever they got the pick.
That's actually a great back.
Done the homework.
Yes, I see a lot of.
Their opponents.
Yeah, and remember what we talked about? Third bans I've often seen to be very, very topical team based bans, like on the team style based bans. First two are normally standard, but even here, TA and DPR, both things which have been banned based on each other's style. So there's a lot of good homework being done. And for all the other teams, research your opponent, guys. This is such an important thing. Take away their big advantages. Don't have to go ahead and ban standard things. Take away their advantage. Do that research which is there. Just click on someone's profile. Read through. Get someone from your team to read through what they have played. What are their tournament picks? And that's what you need to do. Yeah. That's ultimate gaming, man. And this is not just what I'm talking about. Today is the final of the Elite League. But the Elite League starts from tomorrow. If you guys had not known about it, the Elite League goes for 1 month. One whole month. Leshrac comes in. That's great.
Yeah, the pushing power of Leshrac. The stand from Leshrac. The Diabolic Edict giving out too much damage to the towers. Mm-hmm. And yeah, I think Elunes want to push this game again. So we might just see a pushing strat coming out from Elunes one more time.
Well, I'm going to put you in a spot right now. I'm going to say you are on the side of Vo'SK. You got pushed badly last time. What's a great counter to a push strategy? I'm not talking about a specific players, but what's a great strategy to go ahead and counter a push strategy?
It's up to you that what heroes you want to give. If you want to counter the push. Like if I've given a Leshrac, I need to think something that will stop Leshrac from coming near my tower.
Shadow Dig.
And we will see Enigma pick or Tidehunter pick.
Which is again a strong pusher coming through, which is ouch.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Yeah, Shadow Demon and Akasha, the Akasha gives out a lot of burst damage. And the Sonic Wave also helps out to clear the creeps,
mm-hmm.
like to shock. It's a kind of a counter pusher. But Shadow Demon picking up it right now
was not a great idea. I understand Shadow Demon. There you go. Invoker, oh, they'll always pick Invoker over everyone else. Well, that actually gives a time for Vo'SK to go ahead and pick Tidehunter and take away that entire push strategy. Are Vo'SK good with Tidehunter?
Yeah, they are good. But already they have given the two, they have given Leshrac and Enigma, and the top lane is going to be dominated for sure. If they don't do something about it. Because after the 5 minutes mark, it is going to be chaos in the top lane, because the mid, so the Invoker will be playing Exort mostly. Exort Invoker, so the Sunstrike, the stun from Enigma and Leshrac, and one more hero, like a carry hero, will be on the top lane.
Interesting.
And the top two towers they can take out easily.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm also going to go try and see something really interesting. I'm going to see if it's possible for us to go and even make a slight guess. And that guess is also going to be around the fact that is it possible at this stage to go ahead and just jump into the game and say this pick will go ahead and give the game in terms of Elunes? I don't believe so. I actually think that there's some science that Vo'SK is doing. I don't know. I'm not that great a player like some of you guys in the stream. So tell me, is this a good pick, guys who are listening? Is this a good pick strategy? There goes Tidehunter's actually been... Tidehunter's been banned. So, instead of picking him, because they would have guessed that the first pick is actually going to be back with Elunes. They still thought that this is a good ban right now.
The first pick is was going after the bans is going to be with the Dire, and they play Morphling. We have seen Bendo playing Morphling in the first game against these guys only. And so they might be, I think Vo'SK are thinking, like, instead of giving them or banning the Morphling, why don't we pick it? Make it a strong pick for us.
Oh, great idea.
Yeah. And the DK ban coming out just to show up the push again with the dragon form.
And there goes Brewmaster. And I think, again, that's a well-researched thing by Elunes, because they saw Brewmaster in the hands of Vo'SK being the MVP in the last game that they played.
Yeah, actually, the Shadow Demon and the Panda lane, like the Brewmaster lane, in the mid, it will be hectic for Invoker to play alone. Because the Shadow Demon will just disrupt him, and then the clap from the Panda, it slows you down, and it has a lot of damage. So it will be quite a harass for Invoker to play in the mid lane. So it's a good ban coming out from Elunes.
Excellent, excellent, excellent call. What would you go ahead and ban? What would I ban right now? Oh, there you go. I was just about to go ahead and say, my dear Windrunner should go ahead and be banned definitely, because that's one of the strong things that Elunes plays. They hold three heroes and go ahead and prevent that against push. And if you look at the way that Elunes has thought this out, they wanted to go ahead and do a strong push, push, push. And then Vo'SK had to go ahead and say, how do we go ahead and prevent the push? And the first pick would have been Windrunner. And just to prevent that happening, they removed that. I would have guessed they wanted to go ahead and pick him. Maybe the first one, the first pick could have been Windrunner, but that was just too much of a guess. They couldn't have done that unless they saw that's a great push coming through. So, very interesting. Very well thought out. Thinking like the pros.
Yeah. I think these guys will go for a bow of Klings now, most probably. Okay, it's a Beastmaster coming out. The roar from the Beastmaster keeps the hero in one. It's like a stun. And you also have the hawk to scout out if any hero is coming near you, and he can do a solo in bot lane also.
I know. So, and Beastmaster actually makes. I have not seen every match here, but every match we have casted, Beastmaster has not shown his presence. So technically, this is what I'm thinking. Please correct me in the stream. This is the first appearance of Beastmaster in the tournament, right?
Yeah, most probably. I think some team has picked Beastmaster before also.
Okay.
I think so, I'm not sure.
Well, on the stream, this is the first pick of Beastmaster, so it'll be really nice. We saw Brewmaster actually come in yesterday in the hands of Vo'SK and turn out MVP. Is that the same thing going to happen with Beastmaster? Is he going to take it away and go and show that the unknown heroes and the lesser picked heroes can also go ahead and be absolutely imba in the game? So,
Yeah, some heroes can be imba if they are played well, but sometimes it doesn't work out. Because there are some reasons behind people not picking up like Beastmaster.
Well, Enchantress, again,
a very good pick.
Very good pick. Tell me about her. Tell me why you think so.
Yeah, Enchantress is a jungling hero. She's like a Chen only. And then you can just take away two creeps at the same time in the at level one, and you can push the bottom lane whenever you want. And Shadow Demon will be there to help him out. To get the creeps into the perfect position to cast the stuns.
There you go. And Anti-Mage, again, a really good, interesting pick, especially against QOP or anyone who has a lot of mana.
Yeah, it is a Anti-Mage is a good pick against Morphling, but nowadays Anti-Mage needs a lot of farm, same like Morphling. And if he doesn't get a, Anti-Mage, if he doesn't get a lot of farm, then it is gonna be a problem for Elunes.
There you go. What's the last pick? 5 seconds left.
Broodmother.
Broodmother. Excellent. That entire lane is going to be full of spider webs and will give her disappearing ability throughout. So you can, if she can go ahead and get enough webs going there, that would be a really interesting strategy going for her. She can pretty much own a whole lane there.
Yeah, and now. the main thing, the problem for Elunes is gonna be if they have to keep one hero in the lane of Broodmother. Because if they don't go.
Thank you.
They don't go in. Yeah.
admins are this of Streamlink. Good luck, have fun. Lackey says a nice shout out to us. Lackey, we love you, man. Thank you so much. We think you guys are really, really, really good. So come on, while they start, go ahead and sing me one line of Sare Jahan Se Achha Kakde.
Not now, after the game.
Oh, chalo. After the game, guys, you heard it right now. I am going to hold him to it. We are going to have Kakde singing Sare Jahan Se Achha after the game. So do not disconnect. We are all good. We'll just introduce the teams right now. In Team Radiant, in the green corner, we have Team Vo'SK, the guys who want to go ahead and take down the crown of Team Elunes. In Fret, we have the Enchantress showing her face for the first time in the tournament. In Loki, we have Shadow Demon. 16 gets Morphling and we'll go ahead and see what he can go ahead and do with the Morph. And the Trickster becomes QOP. And finally, Broodmother comes and shows her face again. And Remstar, my favorite guy who tells me that I have not shown his skills. I will focus on him, Remstar. Don't worry about it. You are on Broodmother.
Okay, and from the Elunes side, we have Prophecy will be playing the Beastmaster in the bottom lane. We will have Lackey playing all as the Enigma again. And we then have Crowley as the Invoker. We have Leshrac played by Evil Ash. And in the top lane, it will be the Bender and Image played by the Bendo.
There you go, and I think this is going to be really, really interesting one. There goes Broodmother. We can see her move around everywhere. I've changed this map colors instead of everyone's just to green and red, and everyone is just going to be team colors right now. So that's what I'm going to be doing. Guys, we are really excited. Just a quick check at the start to go ahead and see the kind of thing. Smoke of Deceit's been taken by Vo'SK straight up, and that is really interesting. And a couple of wards there. Poor Man's Shield comes in for Anti-Mage, and that is something which he wanted to do, along with Crowley taking Blades of Attack. But everywhere else, you pretty much see a standard. Lots of tree, a lot of branch, lots of branches, some agility issues for Morphling, but that's about it.
Yeah, the top lane, sending Broodmother in the top lane, it is a good idea, but after 5 minutes or 3 minutes, when Enigma starts coming in the lane with a sentry ward, she can't stop the push done by Leshrac and the Enigma at the same time. She can't.
There you go. And
so we'll just have to see how it goes for Broodmother in the top lane.
great quick levels in the middle lane by both of both the solos, the QOP and by Invoker. Both of them are level 2s and they have just made their levels. You also see that everyone else, the quick level by Anti-Mage and a quick, everyone's reached level 2 really, really quickly. Great solid push that they're trying to go ahead and do, but QOP does not have enough health to go ahead and fight Crowley in the bottom lane. At the top, there is a nice confrontation that is currently happening between Lesharak and Broodmother. Broodmother is just scouting and seeing whether she can go ahead and get some nice kills going. But Lesharak stands close by. There are lots of webs there and that entire lane will pretty much be owned. She tries and goes and gets on Anti-Mage but does not go ahead and get the Harris going really well. We'll probably have to fall back. At the bottom lane, the confrontation's literally happening between Prophecy, who's playing Beastmaster, who's going on against 16 in as Morphling, and as Shadow Demon, who's playing, who's been played by Loki. So that's a solid combination going on at the bottom. So 2v1 at the bottom, 2v1 at the top, and 1v1 there. We do see the jungling hero of Enchantress going and working there, and on the counter we see Enigma also jungling.
We'll have a great match to watch every day in the night.
So don't miss our weekly our daily cast that's going to be there. Great matches coming in your way. Interviews we will actually have for the first time in Indian gaming. Great interviews before every match. You'll talk to the team before the match. You'll see what they're thinking, who are their players. And I'm going to run very quickly into the game and more talk when the next time we actually have a pause.
And the flank, the sentry wards are just going towards the top lane with the flank courier.
Oh, a DD rune has been picked up. That's actually absolutely cool. Let's look at quick last hits, which is there. You do see some level issues coming up. No, not really. Everything's running fine. I think everyone's playing really well. As you had said, Loki is suffering a little bit. Because he is alone, but where is Loki? There he is. He is on level 2 and he's not getting too many dens. Morphling is stealing from him and his experience is not really going as high, or his money is not going really high. He's sitting on 238.
That's the way it is played. The Shadow Demon will only be supporting Morphling to, so that Morphling gets up his farm, mm-hmm. and so that they can win the game. The Morphling will win the game for them. And look at Enchantress catching out Rexxar. Just a little bit of harass and the wave also.
But great Beastmaster pullback. He is fine. There are now three heroes on the bottom, and that should be fine. I do see.
Yeah.
Enigma going and jungling.
In the top lane, the sentry ward is dropped down. Lesharak misses the stun on Broodmother.
We do see Lesharak walking around. Broodmother is slightly slow off web, so that's a really important fact for her. She needs her web everywhere.
Rexxar goes
down
while we were seeing top.
I am so sorry, we did not catch that. Oh my god, just a little faster next time. Just call me out, it'll be cool. But that's okay, we'll probably go ahead and see the kill very soon.
Okay, I can just give you a brief explanation. The disruption by Shadow Fiend was done on Rexxar.
Mm-hmm.
Enchantress came with the creeps, mm-hmm. and the troll.
Mm-hmm.
We caught him, and then the wave did the work.
The wave killed him, man. The wave killed him.
Top lane. Edict.
There she goes. Lesharak is going to be ganked very, very quickly, which is there, and that's a great call, which is there. We were there. The map moves very, very quickly, guys, and remember, sometimes the stream will not be really good because we are not casting off a replay where the auto director is in place, which says we have to keep on running around left, right, and center, so that's okay. We do have Enchantress going and standing at the back and saying pausing. Happened before or after the game, but we don't have to go ahead and talk about music. We have to go ahead and talk about playing, and the game's back.
And we are back. The game has started.
And we have Broodmother standing there and waiting for some opportunities to go ahead and strike against Bendover. And my game has now stuck. Are you guys seeing everything happen? My game is now lagging.
Yeah, I can see everything. Yeah, okay.
Okay, good.
It will settle.
It settled down. We are all back. Yeah, it's sorry for
rotation and the 5 minutes mark is done, and now they want to push the top tower. And Broodmother can't do anything because if she comes out, there's gonna be double stun and then the edict damage. So it is gonna be hard for her to sustain the lane for some time. The T1 tower is surely to go down.
Well, I don't know whether she can go ahead and do this alone. There is definitely an issue. The T1 tower is getting pushed, but there is some creep coming. No, there is no creep support which is there. She's going to be all alone. She is sending her little spiderlings, but I don't think they'll be enough to go ahead and hold them. The spiderlings are doing a valiant fight, and here comes the support. And I think the tower will fall in. She's gone ahead and done a fortify right now. This just might hold. The creep is supporting, which is there. Here comes the support on the right side. Here goes the gank. There is the definite kill on anti-mage, but they will go ahead and do this. Whether this is going to go ahead and get killed, it was five. There was an invisibility rune which was there.
Definitely a good save. Just it was almost gone down if Akasha and Shadow Demon didn't come to save the top lane. It is on 180 HP at the moment. Okay, the stream is offline.
It says offline? Are you sure? It says offline?
Yeah, offline.
No, there is a 3 minute delay, right? So I don't know whether there is.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Oh yeah, okay, it's showing live.
Yeah.
Okay, and just by that time, Queen of Pain just took out. And now...
great attack coming at the top right now. We are going and seeing down, which is the...
Broodmother
will definitely go down, and there she goes, which is there. There is an attack that is going on Shadow Demon right now, and everyone is going and running after him. That he needs to go ahead and get out of there as soon as possible, which is there. Queen of Pain might actually get ganked because she's on the right, but she goes and jumps and makes sure that she gets away. And that's actually a great save, which is there. Guys, on the stream, there is a 3 minute delay so that there cannot be any stream hack. So when you see the stream offline, that's not really offline. With them having unpaused, it takes about a minute to settle. So yeah, it was not offline. It says offline, but it's not offline. It's just delayed by 3 minutes.
Yeah, and now it is sure for the T2 tower to go down because they have the creep stacked up in the top lane with the siege, and Broodmother will come on the top lane just to see if she can do anything about this.
Puts a couple of observer wards, but I don't think this will be enough. There is 3v1 coming along with creep. This is going to be really tough for her. She gets 41 gold and runs out of there because she cannot go ahead and sustain this at all. She needs someone to go ahead and support. QOP is transitioning if you go ahead and look at the back, but she is too far away. And if she does not get here on time, she might actually lose her life. She is about 10% away. Here goes the attack. There is a zoom in coming in. Locky is here. The Broodmother is going and focusing on Leshrac. Leshrac will definitely go down. There goes Leshrac. There goes Shadow Demon. And now there's an attack on Anti-Mage. I don't know whether this is going to be very costly. Anti-Mage will definitely go down. And let's see whether they can go ahead and get Enigma. Enigma's got one hit and is about 20% life there. Is going and moving right now. And there goes this one more shot and one more. That's a great kill sequence that they go ahead and go down. Elunes actually lost a lot. Which is there. That is...
At that time, Enigma had a chance to use a soul ring and cast a black hole so that Anti-Mage could live for some time and could get away.
Yeah, well...
But
Vo'SK...
Maybe he didn't realize that.
Well, I think Vo'SK is hearing what I'm saying, guys, because Vo'SK is up 8-2. So, that is...
Just look at the bottom lane where Rexxar is playing. Look at those stacks and how he's playing it. To just gain those level ups.
There you go, man. He is alone. He is soloing this and he is making it count. He is going and farming to glory. There is definitely Beastmaster. He is going and taking all the farming animals there, and he's basically got a zoo for himself. And there he goes.
In the top lane. Watch the top lane.
The top lane, which is there, has been called out here, which is there. We are looking at Anti-Mage being focused down by Broodmother. It's 3v1 right now and definitely gets taken down, which is their great map presence for you, Kakre. Thank you very much for that.
And now, we see Enigma, Invoker and Leshrac all of the three moving top lane, and the Enigma has the black hole invoker with the tornado, but the tower is gone, the damage is done, and I think a smoke coming out from the Radiant.
Oh,
just let's see what happens.
The smoke's coming out.
I think this is a bad idea.
Oh god, there goes Enigma. There's got the attack on Enigma. Enigma is definitely going to be held down. There goes the black hole.
What a black hole.
Yeah, that's a great black hole. Enchantress definitely goes down, but and so does Shadow Demon. That's a great counter. Just shows you what map presence, but whether they're going to get Invoker for this, I don't know. Invoker is getting away with it, but they are focusing on Leshrac right now to go ahead and get that. The tower's going and attacking. They need to get out of there really, really quickly. Leshrac definitely goes down. And QOP.
That black hole was an insane black hole, getting three heroes caught in it. Broodmother walked into the black hole. I don't know why. She could have just stayed behind or gone for the Leshrac behind, who was out there behind besides the Enigma. And catching, Enchantress and Shadow Demon right out there, died out there, and Akasha just came for to kill. He casted the Sonic Wave on Invoker, but the invoke done by Invoker was pretty quick with the Ghost Walk, and he got away.
There you go, man. And I always like to go ahead and see top tower. There it is. Top tower is getting focused down. Lackey is going in, holding his own as much as he can, but there is a brood.
Watch the bottom lane. Watch this, Akasha.
There he goes. There he goes down. Great presence, which is there. 2v1 gank, which they made sure that he goes and gets taken down. And now they will go ahead and see where the Broodmother. No, they. Sorry, what's this called? Morphling is moving back. Morphling definitely moved back.
There was no reason for Akasha to go there. If she wanted to buy something, she could have just gone near the Roshan and bought something. I don't know why she went there.
Yeah.
Because if she didn't, then she would have been safe. And if she didn't fight the Leshrac, she could have blinked away.
Point taken. I think that was very valid. You do see Broodmother coming back and trying to push the tower and goes and sees, but the Invoker definitely catches her out. Whether they can go ahead and focus on her is going to be no. She's just going to be too fast. He's just 1v1 against her. And she does exit out of it and goes and farms some animals. In the middle, we have seen QOP is being dealing massive damage. She's on mega kill, remember. She is definitely doing fairly well. And there goes the Smoke of Deceit. Whether the Shadow Demon can go ahead and get on behind someone, which will be really interesting. He is going and supporting Morphling, but is he got anyone in his lane? They have Anti-Mage. Let's see whether they can go ahead and focus on Anti-Mage, or they're just going to waste that Smoke of Deceit, because I think it is going to go away very, very soon. It's half.
Okay, just watch the top lane. We'll see something very...
There goes this... And Queen of the Broodmother is definitely going to go ahead and get pulled down really, really quickly. That was such an easy kill. There was 3v1, and they got it, and they'll get some. And the middle tower has also fallen for the Dire, because the just creeps have gone and done it, because QOP had to move away to go ahead and save Broodmother, but Broodmother was not saved, and they also lost a tower. So that's a good exchange.
Yeah. But they used the sentry and the dust together, so they wasted 180 gold of the dust if they wanted to use the sentry.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, actually, that's just one of those two would have been enough, but I think that's just overkill on something. QOP is definitely going back, looking at invisibility, picks up the invisibility. She definitely has bottled it and not used it right now. Quick level check. QOP at 10, and at the bottom, we have Shadow Demon at 6, and that's the overall range. Experience also being about the same. Gold, everyone's tanking is about 1,000 gold at the top. Morphling's not got too much. Total gold about 5,000 for QOP, and again at the bottom for Shadow Demon. Cool. On terms of mega kills, you do see QOP sitting on a mega kill right now, so anyone who gets her will definitely get a gold boost.
Oh no, it's over.
Oh, you've got...
It got over in the Leshrac, near the secret shop.
Okay, so yeah, that was definitely taken down, my bad. I'd not... the QOP has definitely activated her invisibility runes, and let's look at where she is.
I don't think that this is going to be a good idea, okay.
There's a great battle that is coming up in the top left, which is there. We have Lackey at 50% health. Enchantress getting focused down. There's double fights that are going on.
And whether they can go ahead and focus on Breeze Master is going to be the interesting. It is 2v2. Here comes the anti-mage. He's going towards this. They will go ahead and get... Anti-mage runs away insufficiently, and there is no kills. That is... Everyone went down to about half health, but could not do this. Broodling is going and moving behind Leshrac, but will not probably get Leshrac.
As you can see, the top tower... top tower. In the top lane, they need to do something to stop the Brood Mother, because if they go forward to gank the Morphling, the top tower is going to get pushed.
And there's a teleport coming in. You have Beastmaster coming in and Leshrac coming in to go ahead and push against Broodmother, and she falls back because she cannot literally take them, take both of them, which is there. I love the creep spread. I don't want to call it creep spread because that's just a StarCraft term. The web spread is a better way to go ahead and call it. And that's definitely going. Matches are really, really close right now. This is the business end of the matchup. You have QOP pushing against this, and there is a huge fallback for Elunes right now. I think Elunes is in a difficult position right now, where they are getting pushed constantly by Vo'SK. I love the fact that this is a game. This game is going, and my underdogs are winning. What do you guys think, all you Elunes supporters? Do you think Elunes can go ahead and get it back right in the stream right now?
At the moment, the Morphling is getting farmed, but the anti-mage has some problems farming up because he's going for the Wild Fury, so that he can later on push it out. So these guys, like, they need to shut down the anti-mage for more like 2-3 minutes just to get the whole game into their control.
Great. Why don't you just do open the item builds and just tell us what's happening right now while I go ahead and keep a look at the map, and I'll call you out if we see any big confrontation coming up.
Right now, okay. Invoker has a face boots and post up, while Morphling has ultimate orb, perseverance, and has 800 gold on him. Anti-mage has a claymore, Ring of Health, and Poor Man Shield with 900 gold on him. He finishes his Perseverance. He's 1200 away from his Battle Fury. Enigma just needs 200 for his Mechanism. Leshrac on Bracer, while Rexar is on 2k gold. He's going to buy his Blink Dagger now. Broodmother, I think he has finished his Orchard mostly. No, he just needs 700 gold for his Orchard, 600 gold for his Orchard now.
Excellent.
And we have a disconnect coming out from
you guys. And we're going to focus on Morphling going and taking a train of 4-5 heroes behind him to go ahead and see if he can go and get away on time. There goes, and 1, 2, and they get him next to the tower. But QOP is back here. QOP will probably make anti-mage pay for that.
Why is anti-mage dying?
Because he just went and said, "I am greedy. Mujhe aur chahiye." But
oh, he DC'd. That's what I'm thinking. He did never ulted Morphling. He could have, if he had ulted Morphling, he was dead before only.
Oh, is he disconnected right now?
Yeah, I think so. ODC pause if needed.
Let's check who's disconnected right now. Nobody's disconnected.
Yeah, I think he was DC'ing at the moment when he was behind Morphling.
And there goes the Necromicon, which has been got by Beastmaster. And now we have... But who DC'd? There is no DC. There you go. Your overlay is now there, and it has been swapped around. Sorry for that delay. Let's see if something we're missing out, some action anywhere. We have Broodmother standing. And everyone's pushing the middle. I think the huge concentration is basically sitting down here. And that's where the fights are happening. Everyone's got together. It is a 4v4 play right now. Slight move to the top to go ahead and separate. But everyone is just getting back there. Shadow Demon is walking, and so is QOP, seeking whether they can go ahead in there. Morphling is back to his old ways and going and looking at 11. Invisibility rune comes in. QOP is definitely being...
Watch Morphling.
Morphling is being watched and has pulled back. And Enigmas and Beastmaster Mark go ahead and try and gank him right now. It is 3v1 right now. Morphling goes and scoots out of there as soon as it's possible, which is there. While that happened, Leshrac got owned by QOP with that invisibility rune, which we could not catch. I did see that QOP activating that because... But sorry, we missed that because we were just following Morphling.
Just look at the pressure by the Broodmother on Scourge. Like they have to, they went for a gank on the Morphling. At that same time, the mid lane was getting.
There's a huge amount of attacks that is happening right now. One, the Shadow Demon definitely goes down. Shadow Demon is one of the weakest heroes right now in this game because has not leveled up at all. Root Mother is putting a lot of pressure and keeps on releasing and has just finally moved back. There is Enigma, there is Invoker, and there is Beastmaster all pulling together. Everyone's moving towards the top. They are saying, let's go ahead and get Anti-Mage. Whether they can go ahead and get him or not is going to be seen. Enchantress has moved back. Enchantress is still sitting on level 9 and has not gained too many levels. If you look at hero level, that's fine. There is 14 to 7. There is now a double hero difference, 7 to 14. So that is getting bad confrontation. Enchantress needs to go ahead and get some levels and will try and do that.
At this stage, the Radiant are at an advantage and they should keep it up, or they might just lose the game like they did in the first round.
Mm-hmm. How much effect does a loss like that have on you mentally? You're a great player, you play well. Do you think about it? Are you thinking about that right now, or have you just put it out of your mind?
You have to they have to keep thinking what thing. What do they want to do next? Now that they have an advantage, like they have the top T2 tower, mm-hmm. What next they should do? Because they need to lock down the anti-mage one more time. Because if he gets killed one more time and they get a good gank out, they can take two T2 towers at the same time.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
If they get a good gank at this moment. So they need to go, because they are just pushing the mid lane and Inoka is just farming on the creeps that are coming to near the tower. And while the mage is farming on the top lane, and Morphling has some trouble because he has to go ahead and then come back near the tower. When he reaches the tower, there are three heroes coming, so he has to again come behind the tower, towards this tower. At this point, they are falling behind in farm and in XP.
There you go, and let's go ahead and have a quick look if they're not going to go ahead and do a match up here. We have difference in experience. Radiant is about 2,500 above, and as far as gold, they're about 5,500 above. An illusion rune has been activated by QOP. She did that last time. There goes the attack on Invoker, but will probably not be able to go ahead and get that. It's a full team battle that is going on here. This is exciting stuff, guys. But there is that tower which is making the huge difference, and they cannot go ahead and get any hits and kills. QOP, the Broodmother might go ahead and try and get a couple of nice hits, which is there. Guts one on Leshrac, but he goes and definitely moves away. They will now push the tower. I think they'll get the tower very, very easily with having pushed all the heroes back, and they definitely get out of the way of the ultimates, which were there. A tango is lying there in case someone needs it. I don't think that anyone needs a tango at this stage of the game. Exceedingly interesting matches that are happening. You see Elunes having been pushed back, and they're now sitting, and their main...
And we have a pause. And now Anti-Mage has his Battle Fury. Okay, so this is gonna be hard, because he can push the lanes faster than what Broodmother was pushing till now. He can push the lanes, but the towers will also go faster, because the creeps of the Dire are going to start pushing now. Because he can clear the waves in 20 seconds now.
Cool. I am going to try and... They just want to go ahead and see what are the Shadow Demon item set right now. So let's go ahead and look at the Shadow Demon item set right now. Shadow Demon should be running at... where is Shadow Demon? There he is. He is with a Dust of Appearance, he has a Healing Solve, he has Magic Wand, he has Boots of Speed, and he has a Town Portal. Nothing to talk home about at all. And he's sitting at level 7 versus a level 14, which is the QOP, which is there. Talking about QOP, I do want to go ahead and say she's been bottling and all the runes. That's really good rune play from her. I've seen her take about 7 of them.
Yeah. Rune control by Akasha is a good thing in the game.
Mm-hmm.
If you get in the start game, how many ever runes you get, those all runes are like important for you. Like in the top lane, I saw in the level when the level T1 tower was going down, she used the haste rune to get out there.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And here goes the confrontation. It is the bottom rune right bottom lane right now. They have 4v5 happening. QOP is going and moving across to go ahead and see whether she can go on Evil Ash. But she's stuck right now. She might go ahead and get focused on, and she will definitely go down. And that was there. I think there was still some lag which is there because I couldn't see her move at all during the game. They're going and focus on Morphling, but Morphling definitely gets away.
And as you can see, the top look at the T2 tower damage done by the anti mage. And look at his farm just regaining. He's just regaining his farm now. And they'll go for a Roshan also now.
Roshan is going to go ahead and fall very quickly. This is going to be very easy. You have Beastmaster standing up for up front and tanking everything that Roshan can go ahead and throw. But at the back, you can go ahead and see Morphling coming in. Whether this they will go ahead and catch them here is going to be really interesting. Yes, they have seen them, which is there. Whether they will go all collect right now, it's going to be there. That Morphling definitely, Roshan has definitely gone down, but that was too late. 10 seconds too fast, and they would have countered this really well. I didn't see who got the Aegis.
It's been picked up by the Anti-Mage.
Anti-Mage gets Aegis of Immortal Man, then that's going to be really, really, really good for him. Because he can now really get up flows and personal the way he can. I think Anti-Mage in terms of the DPS, I think Rikimaru, which is the only guy who goes and does constant DPS at the level he does. So at the end of the game, you don't want to go ahead and get in on his bad side at this stage of the game.
But if Morphling takes out a replicate of Anti-Mage, it's going to be hard for him also. But the Manta coming out from the Anti-Mage is going to be a problem for Morphling. Because he's going to be out of mana after some two, three seconds.
Yes.
Not even I'm seeing a lot, 2-3 seconds, but it will take some time. But yeah, he's going to be out of mana very soon.
Well, that's anti-mage, man. That's what his main role is. He is anti any mage. And you give him mana, he will go ahead and break you so bad with it. Great. Yeah, I think great pushes that are going to come up from the bottom right now. They are trying to take that tower down. And you see the entire dire side collecting from the top and pushing from the top. And they should be able to go ahead and push a tower. But this is really, really far. This is the huge concentration of people here and a huge concentration of people here.
They are trading the T2 for the T2, so the Daya have they know what they want. They are trading the T2 tower from the top lane towards the T2 tower on the bot lane.
Yeah, and that's the trade that has been done. I think this is becoming very similar to what happened last time, and this is the time where they have to go ahead and understand, do they leave that right now or do they go ahead and push straight in and take the T3 tower right now? They have left Crowley back and they have left Leshrac back. And whether they're going to try and start pushing that is going to be seen very, very quickly. And the T3 tower is getting pushed on both sides. You have Morphling who's trying to go ahead and defend against creep, and that should be fine. And Leshrac is channeling back, and I think Leshrac should be out of there. I think T3 is sufficiently defended. And there goes the whole kill, which is there. Shadow Demon falls away again, and Prophecy also fell down. The Invoker is just getting very tired, and there goes the Broodmother, which is there. So this is absolutely great. This is a big pullback that the Dire is doing right now. The Enchantress is trying to scoot away from there, but I don't know whether she can or not. This is a great jump which is there, but she's been bottled, which is there. She's trying to get away from there, and Leshrac goes there now. Oh, there is no place for her to run away, and then she goes and gets killed from both sides, which is there. She tried her best, and that's a great pullback, guys. If you see that, which is there, they've got one kill for four kills, and that was phenomenal. And the team is now at 14-13, my bad. And you see the experience earned, which is there, straight away in the favor of the Dire right now. And the gold earned is also coming back. I think this is reminiscent of what happened earlier. So these guys really, Vo'SK, really need to pull up their socks and say, this shall not happen again, and we shall go ahead and win. Here comes Anti-Mage and Trust, who will start pushing the T1 tower in the middle. And that's going to be a quick push. If he can get through, he will go ahead and make very, very short work of that.
That's what I'm talking about. That they need to keep the advantage from at their side only. If they give some advantage to the Dire, they're really going to take full advantage of it. You can't leave a single gank now. Like a small mistake is going to cost them the game.
So what would you do in this? Would you go ahead and take the T3 tower from the bottom, or would you go straight push to a tower to the top lane where they have nearly made it all the way through, or the middle where they have nearly made it all the way through?
I would like to gank, take a smoke and gank Invoker or the Leshrac, or Enigma.
Mm-hmm.
I would like to take out one hero from them,
mm-hmm.
so that I can push a little bit easily.
Mm-hmm.
Because Invoker, he's about to get his Hex, which is gonna, like the Morphling is gonna get Hex because he doesn't have a BKB. He just has a Lincoln Sphere which can be triggered by Leshrac or Enigma.
Mm-hmm.
So I think it's gonna be difficult for them, and Elunes is making their comeback in this game again.
I can definitely see it happening right now, and I am getting very, very, very perturbed by my support team, my underdog team. My underdog team needs to do the anti-mage goes and gets a mana style, which is there.
Yeah, he just got the mana style in 6 minutes.
Yep.
Like from 23 to 30, so it's 8 minutes. After the Wild Fury was done.
There you go. And
in the mid lane.
Yeah, there's a huge mid lane fight that is happening right now. And there goes Broodmother. Broodmother will not survive that entire attack. It was 4v1 and this is bad confrontation. Here comes Morphling's Illusion, but that will go ahead and get moved out very, very quickly. Elunes is hunting in a pack, and unfortunately we do not see Vo'SK going and moving together. They can no longer, this is not easy anymore. It's 30 minutes into the game, with even with the disconnections and the waits. This is a 20 minute game. This is about what the time where people need to hunt in packs. This is not happening. They need to hunt in packs and it's not happening. We still see Enchantress at level 12 going and working alone. We see Morphling going into another separate lane to go ahead and defend against the T3 tower. You do have...
Mm-hmm. And they need to get a smoke and just go for a gank to the Enigma. Mm-hmm. Because he's carrying the gem, so that Broodmother can get the freeway. They need to keep a silence on him by the Broodmother so that he doesn't give a black hole in the fight.
Mm-hmm.
Because Elunes know that they can't push at this moment, so they are just farming and turtling it.
Mm.
But now the pressure is coming on Vo'SK because the mage is getting farmed, and they also know that a farm mage can win games.
Mm-hmm.
Even though they have a farm morphling.
Well, this is getting to the part where I am, my heart is racing. I want to go ahead and see what's going to happen. If I wish I could fast forward this game, but we can't fast forward Dota 2, guys. We have to go ahead and watch things happen. And this is the time where everyone's hands start shaking. This is the business end of the match. I think the match will finish in the next 6 to 7 minutes, because this is it. Either the total is going to win, either or they have to go ahead and get the anti-mage. He is sitting in level 17. You have to look at which is there. He's just leapfrogged everyone. He is above Queen of Pain. Remember, QOP was at the head of it earlier, but he is now farming left, right, and center and moving very quickly. I think Elunes needs to go ahead and hunker down, get into a great boss fight, put their money where their mouth is, and just go ahead and take down the other team really, really, really quickly.
Actually, Elunes doesn't need to do anything at this moment.
No, sorry, Vo'SK, my bad. Vo'SK,
yeah.
Vo'SK needs to go ahead and do that. Anti-mage might go ahead and get focused down on here. There goes Queen of Pain, which is there, takes half of his life. They are focusing on him, but he gets out of there really, really quickly. And that
just look at the damage into the towers and to the heroes.
Yeah.
Did he throw a Aetherial on anti-mage?
Yeah. He did.
And it didn't damage him at all?
Nope. Yeah, he is now, anti-mage is literally what I would call an Imba hero. I personally kept him selected throughout so to see what he's been doing. He's now moved to the top. He is really, really, really good. He keeps on using his blink very actively. He is down to half life, but he is going to, he makes life. Here comes the big fight. I think they're all collecting together in the middle to go ahead and push down. One of them will keep an eye. Enchantress will go ahead and make sure that anti-mage won't come back. Anti-mage is very, very far, but they are still not pushing the middle tower, and they will go ahead and fall back and wait.
Yeah, they're going for the anti-mage. I don't know why they're going for the anti-mage. They can just stay there, deward the dire side, ward, keep their wards in their side, and then just go for a gank.
Yeah.
Because now look at them. They're traveling towards the tower, and then they leave from the top to the top T3 tower where the anti-mage is rushing towards.
Yeah, so there is Enchantress who's going and moving back, and they're solely focusing on one. I know it's a great idea to go ahead and do, but he is very strong. Here goes Queen of Pain, and he wants to go ahead and disappear. Enchantress drops down, but he is now going and
I don't think they can go around. He can actually take 2v1, he can take on Enchantress and Queen of Pain easily, but he does not, and he moves away because Shadow Demon has come in. But he's just going to be out there. Just look at the speed. I think he's currently moving at 320 plus 98. That's about 320-ish speed. And comparison to that, there is about 360 and 350. He can go ahead and just outrun them without even using Blink. So he can run away from them. And while that is happening, you see the entire bottom, everyone together, all the other four heroes are pushing together. He's just this big, great bait that is now hanging in front of Vo'SK, and Vo'SK is going for it. And behind that bait, they are going. Elunes is going and taking down towers left, right, and center.
Yeah, this is what I'm telling you. They don't need to rush at this time. Elunes don't need to rush. But the pressure is coming on Vo'SK, and they can't think what to do at this moment. Because in the top lane, anti-mage is pushing and he's getting more and more farm. While in the bottom and the mid lane, as Vo'SK are pushing towards the tower, then they come behind and then the other heroes are getting farm. So in all, Elunes is getting farm from all the three lanes. And the T3 tower will go down if they leave the top lane.
Well, guy, if you look at it this way, at 29 minutes, this is where Vo'SK was, and at 36 minutes, this is where Vo'SK is. So, great job, Elunes. They've pushed back, and you have to understand there are no T1, no T2 towers anywhere, and the Radiant definitely have a T2 tower here. They have a T2 tower here. But despite that, they are falling back, and Elunes is getting everything. And they're going to go back on Roshan one more time. Guys, and with two Aegises, this is just going to be two free lives.
This gang could be the turning point for the team.
There we go. We'll see whether they can go ahead and get that or not. They have all collected, but they have disappeared. Whether they're going to try and focus on Roshan is... Maybe they should focus on Roshan. I think
no, the Hawk is watching them. And then from the top lane, from the upper slope, they're just going to be Roshan.
And here comes the rush. I think that was a great bait that finally Vo'SK did to go ahead and get the other team here. But they're not taking a confrontation down. And again, they fall back. Well, finally, I think they're going to move. There's a lot of creep that is moving in the middle, and there is one, two, three, maybe four heroes, five heroes who are going to be going down up middle. This is going to be interesting whether they can go ahead and move anywhere to see anywhere, but no, they are just changing lanes and they're literally trying to catch people off position, but they're not getting people off position, and QOP will start working on Roshan probably again. And yes, she definitely sees. Morphling also comes in. Enigma has definitely got a Blink Tagger going, which is there. That's going to be really interesting, which is there. But at the back of this comes the entire one, two, led by Anti-Mage. They're all here. This might be a great battle right now, but they do not take any confrontation. Morphling still there.
Yeah, I think this gang will be won by Elunes.
Elunes goes and starts tanking on... He blinks at the wrong position, Anti-Mage just blinks to the wrong position, and he has to wait for him to come down. And there goes Enchantress. I think Enchantress is definitely going to go ahead and fall down. That's the definite first kill which is there. And there's a black hole which goes down. Broodmother is definitely going to fall, and there goes Morphling. Morphling is also going to go down. The three kills, four kills which is there. They're definitely got they're on top of them. This is now gone from a game they were winning to a game that they're losing. I don't want to call it the South African curse, but they look like chokers, man. They're playing this. I don't want to go ahead and say that this is the team I was supporting, but they really need to pull up their socks. This is not going to happen otherwise. They really need to go ahead and focus. Dig deep down, go into a good confrontation, push a tower, ignore people. And here comes the center push, which is there. This is literally the ride which comes down. It's like tan, 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 tan. The Imperial March, and here they are. There goes that tower really, really quickly. T2 is going to fall in about 2 seconds flat.
Yeah, they can take the T3 tower also. They won. But they're at. They won.
If they want, they can take the racks with them. Look at that. QOP's ulti isn't affecting them. There goes Enchantress. And they can't do GG.
Yeah, there is the GG, man.
Yeah. They needed to keep the advantage. They couldn't keep the whole advantage what they had in the start game.
Yep.
Yeah. They made some small mistakes and that causes the match.
Well, the Elunes officially takes the Comeback King award besides going and doing this twice against the team.
I think it's a fake GG. Okay.
It is a GG. They are not going and doing this. No, the fake GG is an official final of a tournament is this. Thanks, Lackey. There you go, guys. I am going to stop this right now. We are going to disconnect and leave the game.